This video is part of a series about getting to know your SmartBoard GX series display. In this video, we'll learn about the widgets on the display. Your SmartBoard GX display includes a number of widgets. These widgets always appear on top of other open windows, programs, and connected devices. To access widgets, tap the side toolbar button, then tap the widgets icon. You'll see a number of widgets, including screen capture, spotlight, calculator, countdown timer, lock screen, vote, and clean up. Use the screen capture widget to take a screen capture of your display. Select the rectangle or circle to get an image of the area you select. Use the resize handles to customize the area. To capture the whole screen, tap the entire screen button. The image is saved in the display's Screen Capture folder, which is accessible through the Files app. Tap the Close icon to return to the screen. Use the Spotlight tool to draw attention to a specific area of the screen. You can move the spotlight with your finger. Make the spotlighted area larger or smaller by using the control in the bottom left corner. Exit the Spotlight tool by tapping the Close icon. The Calculator widget opens a calculator for performing simple math calculations. Use the Countdown widget to display a countdown timer on screen. You can personalize the timer by selecting the Edit icon to change the timer's name and duration. You can start, pause, or reset the countdown. Press and drag the timer to the left to show more options. These options let you make the timer count up instead of down, and you can also delete the timer. You can add up to 6 additional timers. When you're done with the timer, tap the X icon to close it. Use the lock screen to lock the display screen. Don't press this unless you know the 6-digit passcode defined when the display was set up. You'll need that passcode to unlock the screen. You can change the code in the display settings when the display screen is unlocked. Use the Vote widget to create instant polls and distribute them to your class or audience. Using the on-screen keyboard or a connected keyboard, type a name for the poll. Select the single choice or multiple choice format. Use the voting option boxes to add at least 2 voting options. Tap Release. A QR code appears on the screen. Have users scan the code with their mobile device. Users can then use their devices to submit votes. To view the results of the vote, tap View Results. You can use the bar or poll options to change how the results appear. To end voting, tap Voting Over. Exit the Vote app by tapping the Exit icon. Use the Clean widget to close all open apps and clear the display's memory for the next user. Subscribe to our YouTube channel for more tips and tricks, or visit smarttech.com. Thanks for watching.